Manufacturing is what has created the modern Western society that many of us live in today. The invention of the railroad, the cotton gin, electricity, and mass production changed the world forever. And now we are at the cusp of a new revolution in modern society, additive manufacturing. You probably know it by its more common term, 3D printing. In this episode, we print samples of ears, houses, movie props, race cars, and of course, rockets! Yes! This is The Future of Tech, a show that prints a new host with every new subscribe we get. We will get it right, eventually. I want to start by answering the question, aren't 3D printers just for nerds printing out cheap plastic mock-ups of their favorite superheroes? No. Let me give you a few examples. The movie industry is using 3D printing extensively for a range of tasks. In Guardians of the Galaxy, the entire costume for Korra the Pursuer was printed. The night vision goggles in Zero Dark Thirty were printed as the real thing is way too expensive. In fact, props in general are more and more designed 100% as a digital model and then printed out when perfected. This is both much faster and much cheaper. As exciting and cool as rockets and big planes are, they are expensive and hard to make. Like crazy expensive, yeah. So one area that is being made 60 to 90% cheaper is the production of surrogates, jigs, and fixtures. Surrogates being placeholders for other components, jigs and fixtures the parts used to holding tools and supporting workpieces. This could be a structure to hold up an airplane wing, for example, while it's being made. It is becoming a bit of a recurring theme on the show, but Elon Musk's Tesla is using 3D printing in building the Model Y. And in general, 3D printing is used for making prototypes of new parts. This makes the process faster, more precise, and cheaper. Okay, there's no doubt 3D printing has a lot of uses, but what you really want to know is how to 3D print ice cream. Don't deny it. So let's look at the hardware and what crazy stuff is happening. If you're after a standard 3D printer that you load some plastic spools of, PLA, ABS, TPE, TPU, HIPS, or PETG into, that's what the materials are called because we need more abbreviations, clearly. You can get a standard use at home version for, a couple of $100s. Something that most can afford, and there are a lot of them around. On the excitometer, it is rating a little below average. But what if you could print a car? Yeah, a car. Israel-based Modix has created the modular additive manufacturing assembler, the MAMA. And oh mama, it sounds like something out of a Transformer movie. It can print car-sized objects at several kilos per hour. Even Modix calls it their personal car factory. And that rates it about holy moly on the excitometer. Of course, it isn't only plastic that you can use to print with. Metals, carbon composites, concrete, and many biological materials too. But more on those in just a minute. What really gets the dial on the excitometer all the way to something resembling a South American football commentator in excitement is the world's largest prototype polymer 3D printer, which has been used to print a boat. Yeah, a boat. And we're not talking a small dinghy with room for two. The University of Maine in the US printed a full-size 25-foot, 5,000-pound boat. And the material, you ask? A composite thermoplastic that is bio-based and made from forest products, which are trees, right? The future of 3D printing will be powered by the cloud. Let me explain. When you print a boat, or a laptop holder, or a complex component for an aeroplane, there will be imperfections, faults, and ways it could have been done better. Currently, you can only wait for the print to finish, inspect it, and then adjust. over and over again until you get a result that you're happy with. Future 3D printer hardware will have built-in scanners which will feed the whole process to a cloud service that will use machine learning to improve the print as it is doing, well, the print, yeah. Real-time cloud processing of prints to make the current one better than the last one. And this will increase production reliability, reduce costs even further, and help the robots take over the world faster. So, I start here in my lab with health. Believe it or not, 3D printing will change the future of healthcare because not only does 3D printing use plastic and metal, but it can also use organic materials. So you could get a new ear printed. Yes, really, or a new nose. Oh, that smells funny. The company Organovo are actively printing kidneys and livers, which one day can be a perfect replacement. What's bioprinting? Well, according to the company, it is the automated fabrication of multicellular tissue via spatially defined deposition of cells. Fancy. Several companies are designing and printing houses. Yes, entire houses. The company Apis Core has printed an entire 40 square meter house in 24 hours at a cost of $10,000. It is both durable and 100% designed on a computer before being printed. The promise of cheap and unique housing that require little maintenance is a real benefit of future 3D printing. It could improve the standard of living in many parts of the world. Yes, that is very cool. I have to end the segment with rockets. Rockets make everything better. NASA is seriously investing in 3D printing of very large rocket components, such as nozzles. They predict it will make the components more reliable and cheaper, allowing more time and effort to be spent, well, actually flying the rockets. However, it doesn't end there because the company Relativity Space is printing entire rockets. So what is the effect and larger scale change to how our society is glued together? First of all, number one, the potential of 3D printing will facilitate distributed manufacturing and as a result bring along supply chain and logistics benefits by reducing the need for transportation, warehousing, and wastage. A case study on an airplane component made using additive manufacturing, for example, found that the component's use saves 63% of relevant energy and carbon dioxide emissions over the course of the product's lifetime. And that will make Mother Earth very happy. Second, number two, as with any major transformation, it could mean significant social upheaval. A lot of the routine manufacturing jobs that exist today could be replaced by 3D printing to a large extent. And that would mean a lot of jobs disappearing and people needing to reskill. Maybe reskill to cloud computing? Shameless plug, but we are pretty good at the whole cloud education thing here at ACG. Check it out. Now, third, number three, as 3D printing becomes mainstream and as common as 2D printers using paper, we will start to print our own parts and tools. We will become a society of less waste as we repair, adjust, and enhance everyday items. Fourth, number four, by upvoting this episode, I can print more episodes like our episode on space travel episode, so you know, that one, yeah, or food, that one. And yes, we cover 3D food printing too. 3D printing is here to stay. The technology has the ability and promise of influencing almost any industry and shake up our society. Fixing broken body parts and printing a new house, it is all part of the future. So do you use a 3D printer yourself or is there another cool application that I have missed? Start the conversation below. Get yourself an A-Cloud Guru account for much more content like this. You can of course find me on Twitter, I'm at Lars Klint, or through the A-Cloud Guru Facebook page and other social media channels. Links are below. This has been The Future of Tech, the show that dreams of personal rocket travel with every new episode. And don't miss our next episode, you subscribe below. Now, how do I get my hands on that 3D rocket printer? I'm sure I could fit in here.